Okay, so now I am going to explain digital system design lab. So how to conduct the experiments, and here we are going to use a digital IC trainer for the conducting the experiments, and we are for connecting this we are using patch cards. Okay, so these are the patch cards. So these are having the connectors at both the ends. Okay, whenever you start any experiment, when you are going to collect what are the components required, for example, these are the ICs, it may be resistors or capacitors or anything. So okay, you have to go first and then collect from the instructor, and then you have to start the experiment. Okay. So near the instructor, so there will be a book will be there. So there, so one of you have to go. For example, two or three may be there in one batch. So only one of you have to go to the instructor and collect all the components. Okay. So after collecting the components, first all the components have to be tested. Okay. For example, if you take any integrated circuit, these integrated circuits will be tested in the IC tester. Okay. So near the instructor. So and then while to make sure that all the connector cables are okay, so there is a method. For example, this is a digital IC trainer. First you connect. Okay, you switch on the digital IC trainer and give the power. Okay. So after powering on, you make sure that this LED is glowing. Okay. So now if you observe this digital IC trainer, so what you are going to do is, so you have to use these IC sockets for inserting all your ICs. So before that, you have to make sure that, so where is the pin 1? Okay, so to find out where is the pin 1, there is a dot, so near the pin 1. Okay. So you make sure which is pin 1, and then put insert inside the IC socket. Okay, before putting the IC socket, okay, this latch should be upward position. After putting, after inserting that, so you make it in the horizontal position. So then this integrated circuit will be intact. Okay, so actually here we have got a provision for connecting 16 pins. So for example, there may be some ICs, so where you have got only 14 pins. Okay. So there, so what you do is, so you just insert, so leaving the two slots blank. So that means you insert in the top position, so and then leave the two holes below as a blank, and then connect the IC. So now this is for 14 pin IC, and again this is for 16 pin IC. So there can be for optocouplers, it can be only 8 pins. So there you are going to use only 8 pins. For all the ICs, so these are all the pins. For example, this is a 16 pin IC. So you can see here it is numbered 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So if it is, it will be in the anti-clockwise direction. So this 9, 10 up to 16. So most of the ICs, so for example, if it is 16 pin IC, so for most of them, so normally 16 will be VCC and 8 will be ground. And for the 14 pin ICs, 7 will be ground, and then so 14 so will be VCC. But so it is not the common case. It may be 90% of them it will be like that, but there is an exception for this rule. So for some of them, so they may be 5 and 12, it may be VCC or ground also. First you have to take the pin specification manual so that you can collect from the instructor, and then you have to find out which are all the VCC and ground pins. Accordingly, you have to give VCC and ground. So it is very important. Okay, for example, let us say this is 16 pin IC. So now this is ground and this is pin 8. So you have to insert so that this ground is extended to pin number 8. Similarly, now I am taking a red wire. Okay, so I want to give VCC. So now I am giving 16 pin to 5 volts. So now we will see what will happen in case of 14 pin IC. In case of 14 pin IC, So if you count like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So then there is no 8 will become 10. Whatever 10 is written here, so this will assume as 8. Okay. So this will 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay. So now 14 will be VCC. So that one, so you connect. And then this is 7. And then 7 you connect to ground. Okay. So then once you do this one, then the power supply is given to this. So then you start making all the connections. Okay. So initially your first experiment is verification of logic gates. So that means you have to verify all the logic gates. So which are all you are commonly using in this experiment. So you may be using AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, NOR gate, NAND gate, inverter, so like that. So and then you will be using flip-flops, so shift registers. But here in this verification of logic gates, so only basically commonly used logic gates, so you are going to test. Okay. So one more thing you have to make sure is, so all these cables, whatever you are getting cards, okay, so these are having correct connection. So to make sure, so there is a method. Okay. So before that, I want to tell you, so here you can observe, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 black connections are there, and then we have got 10 terminals as red. So these 10, we are taking it as input. So another 10, we are taking it as output. So now let us say I want to give so input to pin 1. How I can give is pin 1, I have to connect, insert one end, so another end, so I will insert to one of the inputs. So and then if I make this switch in the top position, so that means VCC is given to pin 1, or high will be given to pin 1. So if I make it in the lower position, so 0 is given to pin 1. Okay. So this is for so giving the inputs. Also, for example, I want to check. So what is in the pin number 3? Let us say pin number 3 is output of this particular IC. So then what you have to do is pin number 3. So you connect to any one of the outputs, that is red terminal. So then suppose if this glows, if the LED glows, that means you are getting high. And suppose if does not glow, so that means you are getting low. So now for this particular, in this instance, so the LED is not glowing. Okay, so that means, so we are getting output as 0. So one more thing I was telling, so you have to make sure that, so all these terminals as well as these connections are okay. So to make this, so to check this one, what you do is, so one of the terminal end you connect to the input, and another terminal end you connect to the output. Okay. So now, so you can see that 0 is given because the switch is in the lower position. So now output I should get 0. So now if I make it as high, so the LED should glow. So okay, that means, so I am getting output as high. Suppose if this does not happen, so that means this particular cable is bad. This particular patch card is bad. Okay, so like that you can check all the cables. For example, this one I am connecting, I'll give one, so I should get one here.